A trend going on social media right now is Black Lives Matter being against anarchists. Essentially, their claim is that anarchists are showing up to their Black Lives Matter protests and are carrying out violence against the state, against the police, and they don't want them doing that. Their view is that anarchists shouldn't be doing this because when the police come in and start being repressive, the anarchists are white, and they're going to use that privilege to try to, you know, deal with the law, a privilege that the Black Lives Matter activists who are black don't have. So let me get this straight. If we combine this with the other things that have been coming out around Black Lives Matter and the use of violence, they've been saying, well, rebelling is a white privilege because you're not going to get killed like we are. So check your riot privilege, I guess it is. So let me get this straight. Essentially what they're saying is that rioting or using violence is essentially Eurocentric and racist. I mean, this really speaks to how liberal Black Lives Matter really is, that they reject the concept of using violence. Remember, they threw out the radicals, you know, last year, when they were purging Maoist elements of people. It was a front group for the New York Maoists. So they kicked them out of the Texas Black Lives Matter because they didn't want radicals there. It's not that the radicals did anything wrong. It's just that they don't want them there. And now we're getting like a whole bunch of this thing saying that violence is wrong to use against your oppressors. I mean, this is along the liberal ideology of the police are a violent, murderous racists. Only police should be allowed to have guns. Which doesn't make any sense. I mean, that's like a blatant contradiction. But you see the liberal mode of thinking there. We are being killed, but don't use violence. Now, of course, Black Lives Matter has the right to choose whatever tactics it is they want to use to fight for their freedom, even if they completely won't work. But you see how it's being framed. Now, you see how intersectionalism works. It's essentially reduced strictly to race, so they absolutely miss the necessity of that if you are being killed, you have to fight back. I think it's got to be recognized at this point that the CIA is pushing this, or at least state actors are pushing this. I mean, if they're literally saying violence is bad or you shouldn't use violence, you're essentially condemning yourself to complete remaining in oppression. I mean, it has to be acknowledged at this point that this is being pushed by reactionary forces. It's just one more example of why this Black Lives Matter thing is not going to go anywhere. They are outright rejecting actual liberation. They are merely asking for the police to just stop killing them, which is something that's not going to happen. And that seems to be a part of the identity crisis surrounding the group. They didn't want to go to the police barbecue because we're not here interested to have a discussion with you. We're interested in getting you to stop killing us, which is right. But then they turn around and reject the means by which you would accomplish that. So this is one of those things that I'm always saying about, you know, first worldist groups. They really don't know what they're doing. I mean, they're arguing for something that they want, but means by which they'll never get it.
Thank you for watching. Want to go ahead, rate, comment, subscribe, and share on various social media. And if you want, you can head over to my Patreon page and show your support. Or you could head over to the MRN bookstore and check out some of the latest books available.